What is up, little gooners? Welcome to the Analog Horror Tier List. Now, before we get into the video, if you like the video, subscribe. YouTube actually made a little feature where the subscribe button glows rainbow when I say the word subscribe. So, I guess hit it so it stops turning rainbow. But if you do like the video, if this hits 200 likes, I'll make a part two to it. And if you want me to make a part two, leave a comment on what Analog Horror series I should cover next. But going over some of the topics, I have a little playlist with some videos of what we're going to be covering, what Analog Horror series we're going to be covering in this video. Now, we can't react to the whole series of each one because that would take forever. So I just have a few videos pulled up as little highlight videos to react and watch together before we rank the series. So yeah, we're just going to be reacting to a little few pieces of each series and then ranking them accordingly. So there'll be timestamps for each different series if you want to skip along. I mean, I encourage you to watch it all the way through, but there'll be chapters if you want to just skip around to each different series. But anyway, starting off, we have Local 58. What's up, brother? Is this Cuphead? Is this Cuphead? I don't like the face of the moon up there, dude. That does not look great. Is his dead wife there? That's awesome, dude. Yep, it's his dead wife. That's cool. Sweet. That moon does not look good, dude. That looks like the moon from Cuphead. This is not great. What is that supposed to even be? Does the moon look like that? What, the audio cut out? It's cool. What is the goal? What is he trying to do? What is the little skeleton guy trying to like do? Go to a cave? The moon is geeking? Real. Oh, you found a grave. Why is there moonlight? He's underground. He was in the goon cave? Mods ban that guy right now. Mods kill him right now. Next, we have Real Sleep by Local 58. '80s ass intro, let's go. Oh, never mind, it is 1983. Let me know if I need to change the audio anytime, guys, because I cannot hear it. So let me know if this is too loud or the audio is too loud. Myth or fact, dreaming is necessary for regular sleep function. Myth. We don't need a dream. Myth. Was that right? Fact. Modern medicine agrees that REM sleep is necessary for mental health. While dreaming can occur during REM sleep, it is merely. Dreams contain symbolisms that can predict the future. Fact. Myth. Oh, that reminds me of myth. Never mind. The symbols in dreams. arise from the unconscious mind, citing narrative meaning. Precognition is a lie. Myth or fact, sleep allows the body and mind to heal and recover. That's fact. That's fact, right? That's fact. Alright. Okay, it's huge. 8 hours, 8 hours of sleep per night is beneficial. I know. That's huge. That's huge. Dreaming is the vestige of a primitive mind. Oh. Where it go? The Kleitman map? Turn to page 9 of my workbook? I didn't bring my workbook. I was not told of any workbook. Chat, did you guys bring your work? Did you guys bring your workbook? I don't have my workbook. No more dreaming. This is what restful, real sleep looks like. Inducing your anti-dream. Close workbooks and watch the screen. I didn't have a workbook to begin with, but alright. Now two minds are alike. This instructional video was customized for you using the personal Kleitman map from your week 6 sleep sessions. I didn't do a week 6. Fuck. Chat, I'm behind. I didn't do my homework. Alright, visual calibration. Stare directly at the center of your television. Alright guys, lock in right now. I don't want to lock in anymore, guys. I don't want to lock in anymore. What the fuck does that mean? I don't like that. I don't like that. Listen to the phrase. Listen to the phrase and repeat aloud. There are no faces. 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 Why is it still in the background? Why can I still see its outline in the background? I don't like that. Read each phrase. Did that just say gooning? What? Hold up. Oh, cognition, bro. I thought it said goonition. My bad. I can still see him in the background. I can still see him in the background. Good night. Who is watching this? I'm sorry, who's like tuning into their TV to watch No Sleep, and they're like, oh, this is a good show. I like this one. I love when the faces came on the screen and told me to not to go to bed. Honestly, guys, I really like Local 58. I mean, they have a lot other work, but I think Local 58 is S tier. Like, there's a ton of other videos that they have about, like, the moon and stuff. But honestly, maybe I'm a little biased because this is one of the first analog horrors I watched, like, a long time ago. but I really like this one a lot. Maybe I'm just biased, but I think this might be S tier or A tier. I think this is actually huge. I'm gonna put an S tier for now, because I do really like Local 58. It gave me a few laughs. B tier, kill you, kill yourself. Mont's killing right now. Scared, angry, sad, happy. That's not neutral. That's not angry. Angry, scared, neutral, happy, scared, sad, happy, angry, neutral, scared, 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 angry. Is this my house? I'd be crazy analog horror. Like it just starts doing its like normal thing, and then it just cuts to like a video feed of your house. That'd be super funny. My house just get hit with an EMP? What the f- What was that? Is he gonna kill the dogs? What's up, Roly Toly? Is he gonna kill the dogs?
Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on here, but something's been stalking around your property for a while now. I'm not sure how the previous people who called you didn't notice.
Okay, something like what? An animal or?
No, well,
do I get murked?
I don't know, actually. Listen, I just think you should go back to your house, okay? Please.
She's gonna get
Okay,
murked.
yeah, you win. Let me just make sure that the dogs are okay, and I'll head back over. They're just right here.
Okay, thank you. I'm gonna try to look over tonight's footage again, just in case it's decided to work.
Okay. Hi, babies. Hi, Mama.
She's about to get murked by that red skeleton thing.
What's wrong?
I don't know. You okay, buddy?
Charlotte, what's going on?
The dogs aren't moving. They're all just standing here.
The dogs are dead.
Well, it's late, so maybe they're just tired or something. But let's just get
No,
you
that's
back.
not it. They're just standing here, not moving. Like, at all. Like, not even their eyes. It's like. Oh my God, it's like they're fucking dead, but they're
Fuck!
not.
What the fuck?
What? What?
Miss Melgren, you need to get out of there and return to your
The
house
red
immediately. I'm
skeleton.
sending your information to the police right now.
What's going on?
Get the hell out of the kennel
Okay.
now!
Fuck, I'm leaving.
What was that?
She's cooked.
Are you okay? Charlotte! Charlotte, are you okay?
She's cooked.
You ripped my flashlight.
Charlotte?
You ripped my flashlight and got. It's gone. Something ripped it out of my hand. I can't see anything. Please, please fucking help me. Please, please, something's in here.
She's cooked.
Okay, Charlotte, I've sent your information to the North Adams PD, okay? They responded that an officer will be there in 3 minutes. If you can find your way out, Charlotte, listen, you need to try your best.
Jesus, please, please, please. Oh, God.
Charlotte's cooked.
Please.
Stay focused. There
I'm
must be
trying.
something.
I'm trying.
Yeah, she's good.
You need to keep feeling her way out, Charlotte. Don't let anything distract you. Great job, Charlotte. Okay, very good, Charlotte. You're doing great. I need you to tell me what room you're in so I can inform the officer.
Okay.
Are you able to see now, even just a little?
I can't see anything, no. It makes no sense. Nothing. Nothing is making sense. I have no clue where I am. It's so dark. I can't tell if it's really this dark or if I'm
blind. Breathe, Charlotte. Breathe. You need to try and stay as calm as you possibly can. Listen, if it's that dark, whatever's in there probably can't see you either, okay?
That's so Gab. She's about to get murked on.
That we stay very quiet until the police arrive.
She very quiet. By those votes? No.
Okay, good. Stay
Dude, shut
right
up.
Where you are. Keep your back against the wall. All right, the officer's just down the road right now. You're going to be okay. Now, listen, I'm going to stop talking so we can be completely quiet. But no, I'm still here. I'm not going anywhere until you're safe.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I should have listened to you.
It's all okay. We're gonna get you out of there. Now, no more talking.
He's gooning? Don't say that. Okay, he actually might be doing it, never mind. Is he still there? Is he still gooning?
I think my skin is moving.
She got gooned on.
Charlotte.
She got gooned on, dude.
And an important test. This test is made up of 5 statements. You will check true or false beside the corresponding number for each statement in your workbook. If you do not have your workbook, simply write.
Okay, well, proceeding to the basement. North Adams Police. Anybody down here?
He's about to get gooned on too.
Jesus, it's dark in here. The fuck was that?
That's definitely a goon sesh, if I've ever seen one, dude. That is the epitome of goon sesh. That's the little react for Greylock. Oh no, chat. What do we think of that? Was it like A, S? How do we feel about Greylock? There's a lot of other really good episodes of Greylock, of different videos, but that was kind of the one I just pulled for this video. So honestly, I think that was a pretty good one. I think this is A, maybe S. Maybe these two could be swapped or something. But for now, it's pretty good. A tier? Yeah, I'm gonna keep it A tier. Because up next, we have the Jurassic Park analog horror.
in today's video, we will showing you how you should act.
Jurassic
like a
Park Analog
Decides
Horror.
To attack into a vehicle that you are in.
Let's go.
Section 1. HVA emergency. In any situation,
that's how you know I pull up to the function like the when I pull up in that Jurassic
Decides
Park
to start
car.
Attacking your tour vehicle. Do not panic. Our tour vehicles can handle the force of powerful animals. But just for safety, remain calm and quiet and grab the walkie-talkie that is placed in the back of the vehicle. Contact security, and we will play a frequency in your car speakers that will scare away the hostile Triceratops. Section 2. CBOE emergency. Although the fences in Jurassic Park are
that fence is keeping nobody out, dude. I could climb that easily.
There can always be a chance of a power outage due to the tropical storms that rampage through the island. This will cause the fences in the park to shut down, meaning that a carnivore like Joker
viewing of this gate is prohibited. Discard it immediately.
At least 6 analog horror series have used that exact same audio.
Viewing of this tape is prohibited. Discard it immediately. Viewing of this tape is prohibited. Discard it immediately. Viewing of this tape is prohibited.
Alright, that was video 1. This is video 2.
It's very bad. There's been a breach in security, and the Velociraptor is on the loose. The ranger on duty...
Did he get killed? Did he get got by the Velociraptor? Oh. He might have. Oh. That might be a Velociraptor. Velociraptor jump scare?
Well, what do we have here? That's right.
The way bro just said, well, what do we have here?
Right. A Velociraptor. Velociraptors are extremely fast. These guys could run up to 40 miles per hour. Now isn't that impressive?
It's pretty
Once
impressive.
You come across a Velociraptor running away from one, well, do you know better?
They are faster than you, Robert.
Who's Robert?
So start running.
POV, you are in my goon cave. I think that one's fun. I think that one's fun. I like the Jurassic Park one. It's not scary, but I think it's fun. You could tell, like, a kid made it. Like, you could tell that, like, someone made it with some, like, free time. It's not, like, super high production, but it's still good. It's still fun. I think this is B tier. I like it. There's a few jump scares. It's kind of fun. I like the Jurassic Park movies. So I think this is B tier. It's fun. It's not scary. It's kind of funny, but it's cool. I like the project. Now we have the Godzilla one. We have the Godzilla one. This is so scary. Oh my gosh. Hold on, can we just skip to the good part? Okay, I've seen this before. This is actually super slow. The plot is, it's just the actor inside the suit of the Godzilla movies. And he doesn't want to take it off. He doesn't want to take the suit off. And his skin has melted with the suit. And, they think it's just, you know, the guy inside the suit. Was that an air horn? Was that like, but he's infused with the suit. He infused with the suit. He... Okay, Godzilla Part 2. So he infused with the suit and
would be able to control his tail. You said his eyes could move and that they are bloodshot. But in this photo, his eyes flashed back. Human eyes don't do that. You need to try and put him down.
Yeah, put him down. Kill him. Who is talking? Who is talking in the background? But I'm sorry, it's mid. Don't think I just watched like 30 seconds of the Godzilla. I've actually watched a bunch of the episodes and it's super drawn out and boring. I just wanted to include it just for laughs. I just want to include it just for funnies. It is. It's C tier, dude. It would be D tier if there was a D tier, but it's super. It's fun. It's obviously someone made it in their free time with like no budget, just some kid. It's fun. Like the whole, oh, he mails it with the suit. There's no jump scares. It's just diagrams. It's for funsies. I can't hate too much, but it's not really good. The following footage may be disturbing to some audiences. Six months ago, police found three paintings stored away in an abandoned storage area, each titled after recent murders. First victim was Carla Gray, found with 36 stab wounds to her face and all her teeth removed. On the back of the first painting titled, Carla's Teeth, was written. This is the painting. It's kind of a funny painting. Second victim was Jackie Graham, found drowned with 27 stab wounds to her... Oh. Okay. Is this in Detroit, probably? Last victim was James Miller, found with the face torn off, his wrist slit open. Autopsy shows that James was alive for several days without a face. Eyes without a face mentioned, dude. I love Billy Idol. The third painting was named James' Secret Face. This is the painting. That's kind of goofy. Looks like a tomato. Two months later, several more paintings were discovered. However, the titles of the paintings did not seem to be connected to any known cases at the time. Here are the other paintings and their titles. Wax Tall Tom. Lisa's Secret Face. Hanging Jimmy. Fuck Toy Corey. Daniel's After the Fire. Jennifer's Last Stare. Scream Maggie Scream. After going public with the case and sharing the paintings in hope of saving anyone that may be depicted, the police received three photos in the mail, all of them also titled. The photos appeared to suit the victims, James Miller, Jackie Graham, and Jimmy. James. Jackie. And... This might be the same person. I think I solved the case. This might be the victim. Okay. He didn't know Wooga? If anyone knows anything about these photos or paintings, please contact. I want to call that number. I want to call that number right now. I'm calling that number right now, guys.
Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
Never mind. That's lame. One final painting titled Self-Portrait was found 2 days ago. This is the painting. The ugly ass self-portrait.
Chance you get!
No!
That's fucking Mandela catalog. Alright. That was one episode of Urban Spook. Now, I actually hate Urban Spook. Urban Spook actually sucks. Basically, there's like 1,000 videos out there and why everyone hates on Urban Spook. And I honestly hate it. I watched a bunch of their videos. I don't like it. It is just edgy for the sake of being edgy. Like, it's just a bunch of gross stuff. Like, it's not scary. It's just gross. It is seriously just like, oh, look at this little kid that got raped and killed. Look at this horse that raped this girl and killed her. It's literally just like, watch me fuck this cat and kill the cat. That is literally what they are. That is actual cases that happen further into the series. And I'm like, wow, this isn't scary. This is just gross. Like, I don't want to watch this. This is just disgusting. There are so many other gross things in that series that I don't even want to say. But no, this is F. This is F, dude. Edgy equals Sigma Alpha Wolf. Apparently that's what the person thought. Because there's no scary parts. It is just, look at this disturbing, like, gross stuff. But anyways, next up we have Mandela Catalog. Probably the one everyone's most familiar with. For this video, we're going to be watching Volume 2. Victim 3 and Victim 4. That's crazy.
You've reached the Bythorn Paranormal Society. How may I help you?
Hello? May I schedule an appointment?
Of course, ma'am. Where's the location?
My home. One.
Okay, thank you. Would you mind giving me a brief description of what you've been experiencing?
I've been hearing things.
Like what, ma'am?
I still hear the meows of my old cat, Johnny.
That's crazy.
The little guy passed away a few years ago.
Really? A freaking cat alternate?
Shh. I don't think it's an alternate. I just think his soul roams the house still.
It's
I
want to
make sure he finds peace in whatever realm he resides in. Do you think you could help guide him?
We can certainly try, ma'am. When would you like us to visit?
As soon as possible, please. When's your next opening?
Well, we could do tonight if you want.
Can you do 3 nights? I'm away from home on a business trip. I'm sure this will give you enough time to deal with him.
Well...
How about 500 a night?
They're about to get cooked.
Oh, hell yeah!
Alright. Sounds like a plan. We will help your cat, man.
He was a little too excited for
Thank
that.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it more than you can think.
No problem, ma'am. It's just what we do.
Hey, back it up. Back it up. You got it?
Yeah, I got it.
You sure you got it?
Yeah, just open the trunk.
No, everybody go really get the cat.
You got it? 'Cause I can...
Just open the damn trunk, Jonah.
So we're going to skip along because I'm running out of time and whatever. Is someone there? Is someone here? Hello?
Open your eyes.
Oh. Who was that? That's just a wall. You're not going to scare me. That's oh. Okay. She might be beatboxing. This might be verbalize. Hold on. Okay, the problem with Mandela Catalog, it's not really a problem, but I think these faces are memed to death and, like, overused. I know this came out forever ago, but, like, I swear, like, they're not scary anymore. Like, I used to look at this and have to tuck myself under the covers because I was scared. Now I look at this and have to tuck my boner into my waistband because I'm horny. Okay? My horny ass could not investigate that house. I'd be all over that. You know what I'm talking about, dude? I'm just saying. My horny ass could not do that. Imagine that top. Imagine that top right now, dude. Crazy. That nothing is worth the risk.
Did you just pick that up? What's the matter? Jack, are you telling?
Oh.
Don't. Just don't, okay? Please. Oh, so now
meow.
You're taking it serious.
Meow.
Dude, I don't know what you want from me. I'm as serious now as I've ever been.
This whole time, huh? So you fucking with me? Was you being serious?
I get that I screw around sometimes, okay? But that's just what I do.
Well, maybe
I can't take it serious with the cat meowing.
I'm just devastated that I'm not as broken as you still are with everything that's happened, and I'm sorry that I can't keep helping you carry this burden.
What does it have to do with anything?
But I'm reaching my fucking limit here. These things have taken so much away from us, yet you still run to them every chance you get.
No, I don't.
Fucking listen to me. You're not invincible.
Invincible mentioned, what is a bad show? We love Omni-Man.
Okay, I know you thought that when we started doing these fucking death marches, and nothing happened, and I get it, but this right here is real, and you should know that more than anybody!
What's that even supposed to mean?
I wish we never looked for your because she is dead and gone, and we were never gonna get her back.
What did you just fucking say to me?
And I'm sorry that these are the lives that we live.
The alternates in the background, with like the cat trying to get their attention by meowing, and they're not even paying attention, they're just like arguing between each other. Like, don't even care about, like, the alternate.
See today, but Adam, if you walk down those stairs, you'd be joining her. And if by some miracle you come back out, I don't think you'd be yourself. And I'm telling you right now that I won't be here to confirm that.
Well, then just fucking leave then! Leave!
The cat stopped meowing, that's a good sign, right? Oh, the cat was fake. It was just a PNG on the TV. The cat wasn't real to begin with. What the fuck? Oh, okay, never mind. The cat turned into Shane Dawson.
What are you?
Germa? That's not Germa.
I did the right thing.
Nobody is coming to help you.
No one's coming? Except for me, dude. Can I get an amen? He's cooked. He does not understand. The cat stopped meowing a long time ago. And he got blue screened. Okay. He's dead. And he's got green screen. Turn off the radio. He's cooked. He's cooked. It's 5:23 a.m., bro. He almost survived till 6 a.m., bro. He would have beat Freddy Fazbear. All right. That was the little snippet of Mandela Catalog. Now, Mandela Catalog is probably the most popular analog horror. It really popularized the genre. And I think it's kind of overrated, to be honest. I think it's good, but I think it's just, you know, it's kind of old. It's kind of just like, it's a little overrated. And I know there's like allegations going on against Alex Kister, but I'm not going to speak on that because I have no idea what's happening. But I think they're just all right. I think this is A tier, maybe B plus. I really don't want to put on the same level as the fucking dinosaur one because this is way more high budget. Can you meow so we can goon to it, please? Mod's banning right now. I think this is way more high budget. I think it's super good, but to be honest, it's kind of overrated. It fell off. But it still is pretty good. Now, as the last one to end this video off, we have the analog horror video that I made. Hold on. We have the analog horror video that I made 2 years ago, and I got 71 views because I like instantly like unlisted it. So chat will be ranking. I can't rank this one because I'm biased because I made it. But I guess watch it. Chat can rank this one. I made this 2 years ago. I was young. It's not great. Animal One, beavers for cool animals in Washington. Cool beaver fact number one. They love eating wood. Another cool fact. They like building dams for no reason at all. Animal two, the black bear. Cool bear fact. Bears love people. Go up and pet them. Another cool bear fact, they are always hungry. They can kill you in 2.7 seconds. Animal number three, the forest crawler. Forest crawler fact, they can always hear you. Forest crawler fact, they wear your skin. Okay, that was it. And yes, I did walk into the forest to record this video. I did literally just walk into the forest and record this video. Like 2 years ago. Alright, guys. Don't care about the elk bugle sound effect. Don't go into YouTube and type in elk bugle sound effect and click on like one of the videos. Because you will just get the sound. Okay, what does chat say? And be honest. No glazing. What do you guys say? Okay, this is biased. Chat is saying S and A. But I literally, all I did for this video was just go into CapCut and clip cool videos of animals and put stupid facts that aren't even true. Like, they love eating wood. Like, they don't eat wood. What? And I literally just clipped dumb shit and went into the forest. And then dragged my phone on the floor. And it looked like the phone was, like, the person was being dragged. Chat is just saying, like, S and A, but I cannot do that. This is B at most. It was cool, but it was just like, it was not that great. I mean, it was fun. It was fun making it. I had a blast making it. But it is cool. And it was just the first video. If it did good, I'd make more videos, but like, it didn't do great, so I just made one little video. I think I actually did make a second one. Hold on, chat. This one's 38 seconds long. I don't remember making this. So I don't know what we're in store for.
Step one, go into the woods. Step two, get lost.
This is just me groaning and moaning.
Oh god. Step three, find its home. Step four, find it. Run, 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 run. Step six, lift the lock. The forest is...
Step six, slip on rock.
Run, run. Step six, slip on rock.
You can see my foot fly. You run, can see my foot run, fly in the air.
Run. Step six, slip on rock. The forest is no longer
the forest
hungry.
Is no longer hungry. Unpaid actor. Unpaid actor. My dog. I literally just had my dog be the unpaid actor in this video. And he did a pretty good job. He did a pretty good job at acting. I think it was fun. It was fun going into the forest with my dog and filming it. And it was cool. So I don't have to put it in B tier. I'm not going to listen to chat because they glaze too much. Chat is nothing but a bunch of little glazers. So I'm about to put it in B tier and not A or S because you guys are a bunch of little glazers. But anyways, that has been the Analog Horror tier list. If you liked the video, drop a like. Let me know in the comments if I should do another video or what other series I should rank. Thank you guys for coming up to the stream. I love you. Join the Discord if you haven't. That's where we glaze in.